Greetings. I have a challenge for everyone in the world who calls themselves Muslim. Do you have any respect for Almighty God? Is the most important thing in your life your desire to follow and submit to the God who actually created all things? The God who created heaven and earth? To follow the God who made covenant with Abraham? The God who sent prophets with messages for 4,000 years? A message that directed the children of Israel to follow him? A message that revealed God to mankind? A message where God said he would bless all mankind through Abraham? Do you want to submit to the God who revealed himself to Prophet Moses? The God who delivered Israel from Egypt by sending 10 plagues on Egypt. Plagues of blood, frogs, gnats, flies, diseased livestock, boils, hail, locusts, darkness, and the death of the firstborn. The God who gave Canaan to the Israelites. Do you? Do you really want to submit to the God of gods? To submit to the real maker of heaven and earth. To the God who sent Jesus. To the God who heals blind eyes. To the God who heals withered hands. To the God who heals the deaf. To the God who heals lepers. And to the God who raises the dead. Then I have a challenge for you. A challenge for everyone who calls themselves Muslim. It is a simple challenge, really, and I am not going to taunt you into taking the challenge. I do not need to. The gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, the true Injil, does not need lies or tricks or deception or force to spread. The challenge is this. I challenge every Muslim on earth to hear me out and understand what I am asking. Do you think it is good and right and just when people say things about Islam that you think are not true? Do you? When you see a video teaching that you pray to a rock from space, do you think, if only the person could believe all the good things I know about Islam, then they would submit just as you have submitted? You have your own reasons to follow Muhammad's religion, but I think some of you understand what I am saying. My challenge to you is to respect God enough to read and learn and listen to the message of the true Injil. The message the Quran says is equal with the Quran. Because if you dare accept this challenge and you do read, the true Injil contains the words of life that Jesus taught. If your heart is sincere and if you do respect God, God will make the words of life alive in your heart. If you honor God and ask God to answer you and show you His guidance, God will answer the sincere request. James 1:5. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that gives to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. Acts 10:34. Then Peter opened his mouth and said, of a truth I perceive that God is no respecter of persons. I challenge you to pray to Almighty God and then listen and learn the message of the true Injil. I think that anyone who sincerely thinks they respect God, anyone who says they believe the Quran is a message from God, must obey Surah 2:136. You cannot show respect to God if you do not respect and learn the true Injil. So that is the challenge. Learn what the true Injil says. Read all the words, not just the half some men tell you to read. and give it the very same respect that you give your Quran. And I pray for you that you might have a sincere desire to hear from Almighty God. And I bind deaf and dumb spirits from blocking your ears, from hearing God's guidance. In Jesus' name, Amen.